Greetings to you all participants on the training on climate change communication. I'm going to take you through the next presentation, which is on the impacts of climate change with local examples from the Seychelles. So climate change has impact on several sectors or ecosystem. And this impact, they come in the form of sea level rise, increase in temperature, and also fluctuation in precipitation or variability in precipitation. Some of the sectors that are being affected by climate change will be the health sector, agriculture. There will be impact also on the forestry sector, on water resources, coastal areas, and species and natural areas will also be impacted. This will be much more severe for small island developing states like the Seychelles. I will just give one example. In terms of species and natural areas, when we talk of the impact of climate change, looking at the aspect of ocean warming, when the ocean gets too much hotter, most of the fish stock might be forced to migrate to cooler water. This might mean a loss of fish stock in the exclusive economic zone of Seychelles, maybe somewhere towards the Mediterranean around Spain, Italy, which will be having much cooler water. It's not something that is new, it has happened before and it might still happen if the impact of climate change continues unabated. We can still look at coastal areas as some of the kind of impacts that we might get in terms of coastal erosion of our beaches. Inundation of coastal land is also possible. Climate change has an impact also on ecosystems. We can talk about biodiversity, carbon storage, and habitats. Human systems also will be impacted. We already mentioned agriculture, fresh water, and health. Even our urban system will be impacted. Transportation, building, lifestyle. Economic systems will be impacted. Energy, manufacturing, natural capital, and industry. On this aspect on energy, it's important to highlight even what we are talking about as low carbon development pathways. So we want to develop, but with minimal emission of carbon dioxide or other greenhouse gases. So it means new ways of doing things, new sources of energy, and even technologies. And also there will be impact on our social systems, aspect on equity, migration, peace, and conflict. Because of climate change, migration has become a kind of coping or adaptation strategy. Sometimes people might be forced to move out of their ancestral homes. I was watching a documentary, I think that was last year, on CNN. And then there is this community in Fiji Island that half of this community is already underwater. So most of the inhabitants, they are forced to move or to migrate to the hillside. And there was this particular family that refused, that they were born in this particular location. They grew up there, they have lived all their life, and they prefer that they should be killed by the water or the sea level rise. So these are some of the things that might begin to already impact us. And for Seychelles, with over 80% of our critical infrastructure located very close to the coastline, it means we might have more impact if there is eventual sea level rise. This is information from the Met office here in the Seychelles. We can see differences in terms of the minimum and maximum temperature. So the maximum temperature has stayed around close to 30 degrees centigrade, and the minimum is around 24.5 or let's say 25 degrees centigrade. And it has fairly stayed the same when we look at the general picture from 1989 until 2018. But having a closer look at the diurnal range in terms of temperature, looking at the minimum and the maximum, we see a range that moves from minus 0.02 to plus 10. What is the implication of this difference in terms of minimum and maximum? It shows that the minimum and the maximum temperature, they are fast catching up with one another, so they are closing up the gap. By implication, places are getting warmer. And I'm sure that those who are maybe like 30 years and above here in the Seychelles will attest to the fact that from the time they were kids until now, things have changed a lot in terms of daily temperature. Places are getting much more hotter. Sometimes we can't survive without ceiling fan or the standing fan and our air conditioning system, which is part of adaptation. So going into more specific impacts of climate change, in the Seychelles, we have issues of warming ocean, and warming of the ocean also might create problems with ocean acidification. We have high wind and storm surges, stress on fisheries, aside from maybe the tourism industrial sector. The fishery sector is very, very important in the Seychelles. And also, countries that are dependent on climate-sensitive livelihood will be severely impacted, and Seychelles is one of them. Tourism is climate sensitive. Tourists are coming because some of them, they want to go for snorkeling. They want to see like the beautiful beaches. What if they are eroded? And we have the aspect also of coral bleaching. We have to remind ourselves of what happened in 1998. It caused a lot of huge economic loss in the Seychelles when the corals bleached. Not all of them were able to recover, some died out. We might even have the outbreak of disease vector. Yes, in Seychelles we have the dengue fever, we don't have malaria. But climate change might create new conditions that might be favorable for the outbreak of new pests and diseases. This is very key to take note of. There is also stress on crop. In some situation, we have to like irrigate because places are getting much more drier and crops, they need water to survive. Not to talk of the issues of invasive species. This is one of the key challenges that the forest in the Seychelles is facing. And the Plant Conservation Action Group has been doing a lot of work together with the Ministry of Environment, Energy and Climate Change to eradicate these invasive species. One of them that proliferates very fast is Meremia peltata. This is an invasive species that grows very fast. And they do much more better when the forest is disturbed and under conditions of climate change. And there is also impact on biodiversity. So if some of the habitats are being destroyed because of changes in climate change, then some of these species also will be impacted. Going to the aspect of sea level rise. So Seychelles is estimating its a mean sea level rise trend that is approximated at 3 millimeter annually. 3 millimeter rise in sea level might look small, but it has a lot of impact for an island state that most of the development is not only on the coastline but on reclaimed land. It has a lot of implication. When there is sea level rise, and then we have this sporadic downpour of rainfall with a rise in also the water table. That is what caused most of our flooding. Not that the drainage are not there. The drainage are there, but the water cannot infiltrate into the soil until the water table drops. These are projections of sea level rise in the Seychelles until 2100. So by 2025, there will be about 8 centimeter sea level rise. And the implication will be that 1.7 kilometer of land will be lost on Mahi. And by 2100, we expect 100 centimeter rise in sea level, which is approximately 4 kilometer lost of land on Mahi. This is very huge for a small island state. The question will be, the loss of the land, where would they occur? On open space, resorts, private property, on critical infrastructure. We see some of the hot spots. You see the red arrow very close to the coastline. The issue of coastal erosion is very glaring in the Seychelles. Because of coastal erosion, some of the beaches have disappeared even around Anse Pointe. And coastal erosion is even manifested. You can see even the root system of the mangrove, how all the soil has been taken out. We have storm and storm surges. This is an area around Turtle Bay, very close to Palm Canal. This happens a lot around the month of October, November. And it's very challenging because we were having a field trip with the students in the environmental science program, I think around the 24th of October last year. And they were making a jest out of the situation that the beach is now on the road. Because you can see huge quantity of sand that is being deposited on part of the road, and it affects the flow of traffic. What about the issue of recurrent flooding events? This used to be my former neighborhood at Turtle Bay. You see the photo to the left? There is no visible drainage when you look at the photo to the right. The water stayed like this. The first photo to the left was taken during the first day of the rain, and the second one was taken 3 days after. So the water stayed for 3 days. What could be one of the problem here? The water table is very close to the surface. So the water table has to drop for the water on the road to drain into the subsoil. This is also something that we cannot forget in a hurry. The flooding event due to the huge amount of rainfall that was received during the last 2 weeks of May last year. Actually, the rainfall amount during the 2 weeks period surpasses even what we get annually. So you could see that the drainage, they are not even right at the brim, but the water is still there. This tells us that most of these buildings, this development, they have taken place on reclaimed land. So the water cannot go immediately until the water table drops. And it's a key issue on some of the neighborhood here on Mahi Island. We also have issues with water shortages. Most of us do not even know where we get our water resources. Yes, we know that we get it from PUC, but what are the water catchment areas? We have one also at the Kaiman watershed, one also at Bilaza at Val d'Ondo. So we need to begin to understand what is the impact. In some places, in different parts of Africa, people depend on water that they get from maybe lakes, streams, river. And they have to maybe like trek for like 2 hours just to access water. During the peak of the dry season, most of the streams, they dry up and people have to seek alternative. So water shortage is a key issue. Maybe sometimes in the month of April, it might peak up. We have the issue of forest fire. It's not too common here in the Seychelles, because it's at a little or maybe minimal scale. But Australia is a very good example that is constantly visited with forest fire as places are getting much warmer because of the impact of climate change. It produces huge amount of combustible material. So with the least ignition, then we have fire. Yes, fire could be a kind of like forest management strategy, but climate change produce a lot of combustible material. The litters, they stay on the ground and they dry
Yes.
up. We have the issue also of landslide. Landslide, because of maybe like the way we have tampered with the terrain, and then with rainfall, a little bit of pressure on the land, then we have also recurring landslide. One key thing that we can begin to think of is to map out some of the hotspot area for landslide, especially those areas that development has interfered a lot with nature. So who will suffer most? Of course, small island developing state, they will suffer. So we are more at risk as a small island state. The land area is small. We have most of our critical infrastructure located very close to the coast. And also, we don't have this kind of opportunity to move to maybe like to land areas in the hinterland because of the small size of the island state. But that is not just all about the story, because the impact of climate change is something that is global. It's not just about those in the small island state. Even though we suffer, we also have problems of like heat waves, impact on agricultural system. This has happened several times in Europe and even in America, that people have to stay in water for them not to die because of extreme heat. We saw this happening in the month of July last year in the United States, especially in the southern states. Lots of people died because of heat wave. And it is a clear indication that the climate has changed. This wasn't the case before, but now it is a daily reality we have to live with. And of course, something can be done. That is why the next presentation that I will be keeping will be talking about the solution. Thank you for your attention.